Good afternoon. This is Rashad Mitchell coming to you live from my YouTube channel. I can see you on my part series. The week that was, college football history review, the 1958 college football season. Now I'm in the month of November. This should be, week number 7, November 1st, 1958. Let's get into it. On November 1st, 1958, Notre Dame upset number 15 Navy, 40-20. Notre Dame looked like they wasn't ranked during this week, but they beat number 15 Navy in Baltimore, 40-20. Fighting Irish stormed to 522 yards of offense behind new starting quarterback George Izzo, who had 183 yards passing, 9-for-14, 3 touchdowns. Halfback Red Mack caught 9-yard touchdown from Izzo on second possession of first quarter, but Navy had surprise up its sleeve. Halfback Dick Dykempat took ensuing kickoff at own 8-yard line, veered at to the right at 18-yard line, slipped handoff to halfback Joe Bellino, who had cleared sailing left sideline for a 92-yard touchdown. Izzo followed 1-yard touchdown blast by his fullback Nick Petrosante, who had 60 yards on 10 carries, with touchdown passes of 34 yards to end Dick Royer, and 40 yards to halfback Pat Doyle. Notre Dame led 27-6 at halftime. Mack raced 64 yards with punt return behind blocks of halfback Jim Crowdy and Marty Stinkles. The Irish built 34-6 edge. Bellino caught 54-yard touchdown pass and made 2-point run in the third quarter, but Notre Dame continued to have too much firepower for the middies. Next, Maryland beat South Carolina with a score of 10-6. Clemson beat Wake Forest 14-12. Clemson was ranked number 19 in the country. Thanks to masterful quarterback Norm Snead, Wake Forest outpitched Clemson 185 yards to 43 yards, but when it came to pass plays for 2 points, Tigers prevailed on quarterback Harvey White's 2-point pass to end Wyatt Cox after the second quarter touchdown. Down 14-6 with 5:14 left, Demon Deacons went 89 yards on Snead's arm to his 5-yard touchdown scramble on fourth down. Wake Forest coach Paul Amon hustled sub quarterback Charlie Carpenter into game with 2-point instructions, only to see Carpenter misfire on time the pass try. Snead's final play bomb was batted down in the end zone. Next, number four Auburn beat Florida in a baseball score 6-5, with quarterback Lloyd Nix and halfback Tommy Lorino going down with injury. Auburn looked cooked by Florida halfback kicker Billy Booker's field goal, which put Gators up 3-0 late in the third quarter. A big effort was turned in on next series by Tigers and Joe Leitner bowled his way through two defenders at goal line to carry sub quarterback Richard Woods' 10-yard pass to touchdown in the 6-3 Auburn lead. Florida and Dave Hudson appeared on his way to touchdown with 7 minutes left, but defensive back Wood knocked him out of bounds at the 43-yard gain to Plainsman 3-yard line. Tigers defensive end Jerry Wilson disrupted pitch-out attempt to force huge turnover as halfback defensive back Jimmy Pettis fell on Gators' fullback, with punter Lorino being out. Auburn was without his best punter, so they conceded safety with 5:55 to go, tremendously to 6-5. So after receiving free kick, Gators stormed back to first down at Tigers' 10-yard line in last minute, but penalty and 2 plays that lost ground forced the Florida Gators into a 37-yard field goal attempt by kicker Joe Hergert. Which he could not make. Center linebacker Jackie Burkett was a brilliant defender for Auburn, while defensive tackle Val Heckman, who went both ways, starred in Gators' line. keep it going. This is week 7, November 1st, 1958. All right, next, Louisiana State. The number one team in the country, Louisiana State. Louisiana State, number one team in the country, beat number 6, Mississippi, by a score of 14-0. Big Ol' Tigers built first win over Mississippi since 1950 on brilliant first half punts of fullback punter Tommy Davis and goal line stands, keyed by center linebacker Max Fugler's 4 straight tackles and 0-0 deadlock of second quarter. Ole Miss took advantage of Davis's drop punt snap and went to first and goal inside LSU 2-yard line. Fugler halfback defensive back Billy Cannon stacked up Rebels halfback Kit Lovelace's 4th down smash. Ole Miss 4th straight run attempt. Bengals defensive end Gus Kitchen soon recovered fumble at Rebels 21-yard line. And quarterback Warren Rabb ran 5 yards for 7-0 lead. LSU's goal team iced it with a 4th quarter touchdown run by quarterback Darrell Mathurin after collaring partially blocked punt at Ole Miss 33-yard line. Totally bound to his ground attack that gained 121 yards, Ole Miss failed to connect on any of his 3 pass drives. Next, number 2 Iowa beat Michigan by a score of 37-14. Iowa's Michigan's jinx died in its 34th year, as last time Hawkeyes had prevailed over their Big Ten tormentor was in 1924. So it was raw speed that prevailed for Iowa after the previous week's Northwestern Victory Foundation had been passed to quarterback Randy Duncan. Hawks soared long distance to 72, 74, 24, 62-yard touchdown dashes, but not before injury-riddled Michigan played to 14-14 tie midway through the third quarter. Halfbacks Willie Fleming had a 72-yard touchdown return on a punt, and Ray Jock, 74-yard touchdown jump around left end, giving Iowa 14-0 lead in the second quarter when Wolverines quarterback Bob Potasik pitched away to his short touchdown pass to halfback Daryl Harper just before halftime. Michigan tied it on Potasik sneak halfback Brad Myers' 2-point run of the 73-yard trip following the second half kickoff. Hawks nose guard Hugh Drake forced Michigan sub quarterback Stan Noskin to fumble at Michigan 33-yard line. Halfback Bob Jeter quickly swept to go ahead touchdown. Wolverines made fumble recovery, push ahead until they died on downs at 10-yard line. And I will conjure with 9 yards voice to Jeter's second touchdown on a 24-yard run for 29-14 lead, with Duncan hitting 37 and 13-yard passes. Next, Ohio State, the number 5 team in the country, was shut out by number 11 Northwestern, 21-0. Number 11 Northwestern shut out number 5 Ohio State, 21-0. In last 90 seconds of the third quarter of nervous 0-0 battle, Wildcats quarterback Dick Thornton threw deep pass to halfback Ron Burton, who made diagonal 67-yard sprint for touchdown. It was the longest scoring throw to date in Northwestern history. In an effort to come back in the fourth quarter, Iowa State gambled on 4th-and-1 at its own 44-yard line, and workhorse fullback Bob White was stacked up. After 3 Northwestern runs gained 11 yards, Thornton raced 32 yards to Ohio State 1-yard line, and on 5th play of the drive, plunged over to score for 13-0 edge with 6:25 left. Offensive back Thornton picked off pass by Ohio State quarterback Frank Kremlis and returned it to the 27 yards. So, quarterback Thornton added touchdown pass to end Albert Kimbrough and 2-point conversion pass to Burton. It was Buckeyes' first Big Ten defeat in the last 11 starts and first loss in last 15 games overall. Afterward, Northwestern coach Eric Posegun was hoisted to his players' shoulders and he lifted game ball into aerial salute. Later, he said, "They, meaning Ohio State, scored 47 points on us 1 year." Which is true. 1957, they scored 47 points. They won 47-6. And they can't cross our goal line the next. What do you think of that? Next, Missouri shut out Nebraska. 31-0. Next, Oklahoma. The number 17 team in the country beat number 9 Colorado, 23-7. Number 7 Oklahoma beat the number 9 team in the country in Colorado, 23-7. Largest crowd at Folsom Field to date turned out to see Colorado, nation's offensive leader with 411 yards per game average, made its annual good try effort to knock down Oklahoma's long conference winning streak. Instead, the Sooners cruise to its 86th win in a row in Big 8 as Buffaloes were held to paltry 87 yards rushing and 99 yards in the air. Senior quarterback David Baker emerged from his demotion to third string backfield to provide Oklahoma the best quarterbacking since Jimmy Harris left for the NFL after 1956. Fullback Prentice Gartz rushed for 117 yards on 16 carries, including a 48-yard touchdown dash in the first quarter. Colorado scored first after quarterback punter Boyd Dowler, 56-yard punt to 1-yard line, allowed wingback Eddie Dove to make punt return a 41-yard deep from 1 yard deep into Sooners territory. So Buffalo's tailback Howard Cook, Big 8's leading rusher, who was held to 18 yards on 12 carries, but rammed over from 3-yard line for 7-0 lead, 9-59 to go in the first quarter. Gartz soon cut through left tackle to answer with his long touchdown run, and from kick holding position, Baker hopped up to pitch 2-point pass halfback Jim Carpenter for 8-7 lead. That score held up to halftime, even though Colorado was to be so shut down that punter Dowler became his best weapon. Baker added touchdown runs at end of 79-yard 30-quarter and 76-yard 4th-quarter trip. Next, Air Force, number 13 team in the country, beat Oklahoma State 33-29. That's halfback Wiggins, who had 41 yards on 9 carries and a touchdown, got Kyle Polk's off toward a 15-0 lead with first quarter touchdown plunge and took second half kickoff 81 yards to set up halfback Dwayne Wood to score on a 4-yard run. Wood followed up later with 46-yard reception from quarterback Dick Sorger to lift Cowboys from 18-15 halftime deficit to a 29-18 fourth quarter lead. Now, telling moments, however, had come in the third quarter when Oklahoma State tally fell to a game single point from 2 fumble recoveries, interception after Wood's early touchdown in the third quarter. So Air Force sophomore quarterback Rich Mayo picked apart the Cowboys' short and medium passes as he directed 80-yard aerial drive capped by halfback Phil Lane's 11-yard catch to trim, scored to 29-25. Next, Mayo completed 2 throws on the fourth downs to plot the clutch 72-yard march, climaxed by an end by Bricky's winning 13-yard touchdown catch with 9 seconds showing on the fourth quarter clock. Filling air with passes, Airman Mayo made 28 of 48, 214 yards, 2 touchdowns, while Philly Falcons fullback Steve Gallios rushed 94 yards on 17 carries and a touchdown. Southern Methodist defeated number 16 Texas in an upset, 26-10. This pair of long touchdowns encouraged Mustangs to stampede to fourth quarter round 2. Rugged win over number 16 Texas, which dropped its second straight. Longhorns enjoyed 10-0 lead on a 1-yard touchdown run by fullback Mike Dowdle in first quarter and quarterback kicker Bobby Lackey's 33-yard field goal in third quarter. And come in by having kept SMU out of its territory all but once. Texas seemed on brink of locking up matters when it banged quick kick to Mustangs 42-yard line past halfway of third quarter. Quarterback Don Meredith, who played sparingly in first half because of lingering hip pain, hit whirling halfback Billy Polk, pulled away from tackles for 35-yard touchdown. SMU trailed 10-6. Big interference penalty on Texas put Ponies at 18-yard line. Halfback Glenn Gregory soon swept a touchdown and 13-10 lead in fourth quarter. Steers tried a halfback pass by Bobby Gorbitz, but halfback defensive back Tyree Willman picked it off for a 35-yard touchdown return. SMU halfback Norman Marshall soon followed with 75-yard punt return for a touchdown. After his receiving spur of a moment, lateral from halfback mate Dan Bowden. Next, Oregon State beat California by a score of 14-8. Oregon State took PCC lead when it overcame an early 8-0 deficit. California quarterback Joe Capp, season-long magician, pitched out on second possession. Beavers center linebacker Doug Basher picked it off and charged 33 yards to the touchdown. Beavers wingback defensive back John Aurelio made winning score possible when he picked off Cap pass late in the third quarter. Aurelio's return went to Bears 33-yard line from which point tailback Paul Lowe hit two passes and swept in for winning 8-yard touchdown. Now, let's look at the AP poll. As we know, at the time, we were going into November 3rd. On November 3rd, the AP poll came out. And on November 3rd, 1958, number one was Louisiana State. They were the number one team in the country. Louisiana State. Number two was Iowa. Number three was Army. Number four was Northwestern. Number five was Auburn. The rest of the top 10 rounded out as this. Number six, Oklahoma. Number seven, Wisconsin. Number eight, Purdue. Number nine, Mississippi. And number 10, Air Force. Number 11, Texas Christian. Number 12, Syracuse. Number 13, Rice. Number 14, Notre Dame. Number 15, North Carolina. Number 16, Ohio State. Number 17, Clemson. Number 18, Rutgers. Number 19, Florida. And finally, number 20, Southern Methodist. That's a look at the top 20 as of the AP poll of November 3rd. We go over it again. Number one was Louisiana State. Number two was Iowa. Number three was Army. Number four was Northwestern. Number five, Auburn. Number six, Oklahoma. Number seven, Wisconsin. Number eight, Purdue. Number nine, Mississippi. Number 10, Air Force. Number 11, Texas Christian. Number 12, Syracuse. Number 13, Rice. Number 14, Notre Dame. Number 15, North Carolina. Number 16, Ohio State. Number 17, Clemson. Number 18, Rutgers. Number 19, Florida. And number 20, Southern Methodist. So that concludes a look at the week that was, week seven of the November 1st, 1958, the college football season, week number seven. Please subscribe to the channel. Like, subscribe, comment, the way we can support the channel. That's the conclusion of week seven, November 1st, 1958. So continue to move forward in this 1958 season. Hope you enjoy it whenever you check out the video. Until then, talk to you tomorrow.